Hello everyone, welcome to part two. So I stated that I'm gonna talk about what actually happened or just give some more feedback about the Greensboro Four. These four men and their lives and how they stood up for what was right, and they were the trailblazers. To when you fight in a peaceful, nonviolent manner, you will get things done with success, and you will also get people on your side to help you fight for the injustice in your community. So make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get right into it. So the four men who were part of the Greensboro Four was Joseph McNeil, Franklin McCain, Azell Blair, and David Richmond. So I'm going to go through each person and we're going to get into their life story and what happened to them today, because we do have some of the members who are still living today in our communities. And so we need to congratulate our heroes, especially while they are alive and well and thriving in the community. All right, so Joseph McNeil, the first person of the Greensboro Four. He is from Wilmington, North Carolina, and he moved to New York after graduating from high school. Now, Joseph attended North Carolina A&T. Now, Joseph attended North Carolina A&T on a full scholarship. However, he found it difficult to live in the South. He made a statement, allegedly, about how when he went to the bus terminal, people were so rude and inhumane to him simply because of the color of his skin. And he just simply was just disgusted by the inhumanity, especially in the South. He earned a degree in physics in 1963, and he also joined the Air Force, where he became an officer in 6 years. And he also ranked as a captain. He worked for IBM in computer sales. He was a commercial banker for Bankers Trust New York, a stockbroker for the E.F. Fulton, and he retired from the Air Force as a major general. He now lives in New York with his wife, and they had 5 children. The next person part of the Greensboro Four is Azell Blair Jr. Now, Azell was born in Greensboro, North Carolina, so he was a native. He graduated with a bachelor's in sociology in 1963. He was very influential on campus. He was the president of his junior class, member of SGA, and the president of the NAACP on campus. And he also was a member of the Greensboro Congress of Racial Equality. Found it very difficult to find a job in the South, in particular because he was known as part of the Greensboro Four. So he decided to attend law school at Howard University. And therefore, he moved to Massachusetts and became a member of the Islamic Center. He works with disabled people and at the Rodman Job Corps Center. Now, one thing about Azell, he changed his name to Jabril Kazan. He also had 3 children, in which one of them also attended North Carolina A&T. The third member of the Greensboro Four was Franklin McCain. He was raised in D.C. and he graduated with a bachelor's in chemistry and biology in 1964. He was actually roommates with David Richmond at the time, and he stayed in school. Well, he stayed in Greensboro for grad school and married Betty Davis, where they had 3 sons. In 1965, he became a chemist for the Celanese Corporation. He now lives in Charlotte. He's an active member on local educational, civic, and spiritual and political opportunities in the community. The last person of the Greensboro Four is David Richmond. Now, David Richmond was born in Greensboro, and he graduated from Dudley High School. He was on the track team, and he set the highest jump record on the track team. His major was in business administration and accounting. He became a counselor coordinator for the CETA in Greensboro, North Carolina. However, he was forced to leave Greensboro because of racist hate groups driving him out of the community. They made death threats towards him, and which it left him entirely traumatized for his life to come in the future. He moved to the mountains in the community of Franklin for 9 years, yet returned to the community of Greensboro to help take care of his parents. However, being labeled as a troublemaker definitely haunted him, and it messed with his mental health that was irreversible. He found it very difficult to find work because he was labeled as the Greensboro 4 until eventually he found a job as a janitor. In 1980, he was awarded the Levi Coffin Award in Human Rights. He married and divorced twice and had 3 children. Unfortunately for David, he battled alcoholism, in which his life was brought to an end at the age of 49 years old. Now, later on, North Carolina A&T would give him an honorary degree to celebrate his life. I think it speaks measures to these 4 men who were trailblazers and stood against the grain. They were so resilient to have fought back, to have risked their lives for us, for a common act that we take for granted every day. I think is commendable, and we should celebrate these men in our actual American history books. Let me know if you know more interesting facts about the Greensboro 4 men. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Until next time.